wearing silly masks and going, making silly noises, and one of them pretending to be the manager.
Sir?
Yeah, and he spoke right as he went,
oh, yes, I'm the manager. Smashing store to manage this. Freshest haddock in London.
I think I've got it. It's Rag Week.
Rag Week?
Yes, you know, for charities.
Oh, I see, some local college or university.
No, it's the Stores Rag Week, sir.
Stores Rag Week?
Yes, yeah, the senior staff don't join in much. It's for the trainees, really.
Not very good for business, is it?
Oh, it's for charity, sir. People are awfully good about it, you know.
Oh, I see, yeah.
Right, sir, well, I'll get you a senior assistant. Ant, was it?
Yes, please, yes.
Mr. Snedderton! Could you look after this?
I don't want him!
Oh, please, give me a chance!
No!
Mr. Harvard!
Yes, good morning, sir. Can I help you?
Ah, yes, please. I'm interested in buying an ant.
Ah, yes, and what price do you think you're paying, sir?
Oh, well, I hadn't actually got as far as that.
Well, sir, they start about half a p, but they can go as high as 3p or even 3.5p for a champion. Inflation, I'm afraid.
Well, I should think one about 1.5p, please.
Oh, yes, well, you should get a very serviceable little animal for that, sir. Quite frankly, the half p ones are a bit on the mangy side. Anyway, what length was sir thinking of?
Oh, medium?
Medium. Yes, here we are. Now, that one there is an Ayrshire, and that one there is a King George bitch, I think. And that one killing the little flitbat is an Afghan.
That's a nice one.
Oh, well, let's see how you get on with him, eh? Ah, yes, he likes you. He's taken to you.
What do you feed them on?
Blancmange.
Blancmange?
Sorry, I don't know why I said that. No, you don't feed them at all.
What do they live on?
They don't. They die.
They die?
Well, of course they do if you don't feed them.
I don't understand.
Well, you let them die. Then you buy another one. It's much cheaper than feeding them, and that way you have a constant variety of little companions.
Oh, I see.
That's the advantage of owning an ant.
Right, well, I'll take this one. Oh, dear, I've dropped it.
Never mind. Here's another one.
Oh, thank you. Yeah. Is there anything else I'll need?
Yes, sir. You'll need an ant house. This is the model we recommend, sir.
When you get out of there?
Yes.
What's the point of having the cage?
Well, none at all, really. And then there's some little pieces of cage furniture which will keep him entertained. There's an ant wheel. And there's a little ant swing. And here, sir, there's a very nice one here. There's a little ladder. You can run up there and ring the bell. That's a trick you can learn.
Will you live long enough?
Not really, no, but it's best to have one just in case. Mm-hmm. And here's a two-way radio he can play with. And then, of course, you'll need the book.
The book?
Yes, the book on ants.
I see.
So, sir, that is, if I may say so, £184, 1.5p, sir.
Oh, well, will you take a check?
Yes, sir, if you don't mind leaving a blood sample and a piece of skin off the back of the scalp just here, sir. Sorry, just for identification, you know, can't be too careful.
I think I'll put it on account.
I should, sir, much less painful. Here we are. Anyway, sir, they always say about an ant, sir, a friend for life, eh? Well, friend for its life, anyway. Now then, here we are. His name's Marcus. Right. If the little chap should go to an early grave, sir, give us a ring and we'll stick a few in an envelope, all right?
Thanks very much indeed.
Not at all. Thank you, Mr. Ellis.
What did you say?
It's not him.
I said thank you, Mr.
Not
Ellis.
Not him.
Why did you say I was Mr. Ellis?
No, he didn't say that.
Yes, he did. I heard him say thank you, Mr. Ellis.
No. He said, I'm jealous.
What?
I'm jealous of your aunt. Goodbye.
Bye-bye.
Goodbye.
Bye.
I don't care who Michael Ellis is.
Papers of all this stand ants with the iron boot of Protestant and Lutheran.
Excuse me, I was in the ant counter.
Papers of all this stand ants with the iron boot of Protestant and Lutheran.
Was it not the Lord himself who said, stamp out the papal sway?
Will Mr. Michael Ellis please go straight to the manager's office? I'll repeat that. Will Mr. Nigel Mellish please go straight to the manager's office?
What you got now?
I bought an ant, Mother.
Oh, devil. What do you want one of them for? I'm not going to clean it out. You said you'd clean the tiger out, but do you? Nah, I suppose you lost interest in it now. Now it'll
really different this time, Mum. I'm really going to look after this ant.
Well, that's what you said about the sperm whale. My pop was having to use it as a gouge.
Well, you didn't feed it properly.
Where are we going to get 44 tons of plankton from every morning? Your papa was dead vexed about that. He thought he was mad in the deli.
Well, at least he's got a free garage.
Right, no good to him. His Hillman smells all fishy. Oh, blimey, there's a tiger. He'll be watched his mandis.
Are you giving that tiger drugs?
Of course I'm giving it drugs.
It's illegal.
You try telling that to the tiger.
Well, I think it's dangerous.
Listen, before he started fixing, he used to get through 4 Jehovah Witnesses a day. And he used to eat all of them, except for the pamphlets.
Well, he's not dim.
All right!
Well, I think I'll go and watch one of the televisions. Come on, Marcus.
Oh, by the way, Michael's been on the phone all day for you.
Michael?
Hey, Michael. Michael! Michael Ellis. Yeah, he's been on the phone all day. He came around twice.
What's he look like?
Oh, I didn't see him. The orange Rumpty-Gooty answered the door. Only useful animal you ever bought, that.
Where is he now?
He's upstairs forging prescriptions for the sodding tiger.
No. Where's Michael Ellis now?
Oh, I don't know. He said it wasn't important anyway. All right, here I come.
The University of the Air. And first this afternoon, part 17 of our series on animal communications. This afternoon we look at recent discoveries in the field of intraspecific signaling codes in the family Formisoidea.
Oh, that's a stroke of luck, Marcus.